I want to. I like to introduce myself. My name is Biz Markie. And well, I'm the human orchestra called Biz Markie. Making music orally is my specialty. When I go, I want to. Girls get excited. When they hear my lyrics, they wanna recite them. I know you're in the mood. Just go with the flow. And I can play rapping records and all disco. Like Beat It, Billy Jean, by Michael Jackson, all the treasures to your ranking. They gon' ask you when you hear me do it. You will be shocked and amazed. It's the brand new thing they call the human beatbox craze.
Make the music.
Well, I don't just do the beatbox. I rock on the mic and all the bomb that I say. All the people like, I get the crowd jumping, get the girls heart pumping. All the party people say, isn't he something? Rock from New York City all the way down south. Saying rhymes and making music, look my mouth. I'ma tell your party people how I began. It started when I'm living in Long Island. Hey, when I was a kid, I used to play in the street, making sounds with my mouth, all sorts of beats. Grown people used to say, what? Grown people used to say, what? Wrong with that kid making that strange noise. It was like for all the flyers and all the homeboys. Then I tried it at a homeboy's basement party. They thought it was a record laying over me. When it came by the DJ and saw who it is, they said, make the music with your mouth, bitch.
Make the music with your mouth, bitch.
Make the music, make the music. waking up in the morning, gotta thank God. I don't know, but today seems kinda odd. No barking from the dog, no small. And mama cooked the breakfast with no hog. Life changes, time rearranges. Visions of my head of one day being famous.
Hello? Hello, caller. Well, the hell with it. This is something new for the underground.
Right about now, you're about to be possessed by the sounds of OG Music Zone, G-Lew.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, it's your boy G-Lew. Back doing what I do. Back again for the next installment. This is the G-Lew Show. I want y'all to sit back because we're going to have a real good time. You know what I mean? Yeah. This is OG Music Group. Now I'm your maestro for the evening. G-Lew. Yeah. We're going to have a real nice show tonight. I got a lot of special guests stopping through. Some surprises, you know what I mean? So I want y'all to just sit back and ride with me. G-Lew Lee. Yeah.
Crank it up and piss off the neighbors. You got your radio locked on to the hottest station.
That's right, that's right. It's the G-Lew Show, and you know it's Flashback Fridays. We're back for another edition. You know, we've been off a few weeks. I've been over there kicking it with my folks. You know, Tammy and Terry, TNT, you know, Real Relationship Talk. We've been giving you a dose of that, trying to lace you up with some good relationship talk issues. Shout out to my peoples, Tammy and Terry. Gave them the night off tonight, but they're probably still tuning in. Much love, my folks. Shout out to my homegirl, Pamela, out there, man, in L.A. You know what I'm saying? Go get her book, all her books. It's out there. D.D. Harrison, follow her at Facebook, Instagram. Shout out to my main, to my homegirl, Jane, J.L. Penn on Instagram. Shout out to Jane, man. You know, she's not always feeling the best. But I know when I'm on, and we doing our thing on Westside Wednesday, Flashback Fridays, TNT, or OG Sundays, Jane is in good spirits. So I want to give a special shout out to Jane. You know what I mean? The homie Snoop even gave a special shout out to her. I'm going to play that a little bit later, man. But Jane should be on cloud nine right now. And she probably came from the dispensary earlier today. Shout out to Jane, man. I've been to the dispensary of my own. I got some good shit over here I'm about to smoke on. Have a good show. If you ain't knowing already, we got the legendary Mixmaster Ice in this motherfucker tonight, man. It's going down the real way. UTFO, you know the legends, man. Who set it off like in about 83, 84. You know what I mean? Roxanne, Roxanne. You know what I mean? You cold wanna be with me. You know what I mean? Kicked it with Houdini. They like the baby Houdini. You know what I mean? So shout out to UTFO, my main man, Mixmaster Ice. He's going to be live on the premises coming up real shortly. So, you know, in the meantime, between time, man, pour you a drink, roll you up something nicely, so something nice, some of that good chronic OG Kush, something real nice. You know, and kick it with your boy, man. It's G-Lew. This is the G-Lew Show, and it's Flashback Fridays, man. Shout out to my boy Snow. He should be on the road coming up to see me, man. We're going to do it real big this weekend. Shout out to all my fathers out there. Happy Father's Day early to all my fathers out there. Happy Father's Day to my father. He's no longer with me, but he gave me the game. You know what I mean? To do what I do. He was a DJ and was on radio, so I'm just following in the footsteps, man. So happy Father's Day to all the fathers out there. Shout out to my bro C-Lo, OG C-Loco. From that 30 gang. What up, though, bro? And everybody out there, man, tuning in. It's the G-Lew Show, Flashback Fridays. Mixmaster Ice coming up. He's coming up in a little bit. So in the meantime, I'm going to play some music, man, you know, because, you know, just give you some real classic hip-hop, man. I'm going to start it off like this. Do this in love and memory of the great Eazy-E. Cocaine is coming back to the show in a couple weeks. Be on the lookout for that West Side Wednesdays. Cocaine's coming back. I mean, that nigga was
a genius. Motherfucking godfather of gangsta rap. Open up a can of worms to all you riders. You know what I'm saying? So don't hate the nigga. This is dedication to my nigga Eazy motherfucking name.
For all the motherfuckers out there, know we're down with this shit. Fuck them. Fuck you. Real niggas. Dedicated to my nigga E. You know who's down. Yo, cocaine. Let's do this shit.
Yeah. Now, dedicated to my niggas from around the way. I know you wake up every morning thinking about when you're gonna die someday. Someday. Lord, I feel so bad for both the wrong and done. And I still can't believe my nigga is just dead and gone. Gone.
Now Eazy does it, doesn't Eazy, but
sometimes we know.
We know the pain. Giving up the gangsta sound.
Real man, cause man, around
y'all. Yeah, this is real.
It's for the E.
A real Compton City G.
Easy. It's for the E.
A real Compton City G.
Real man, it's for the E.
Hypnotized to the motherfucking gangsta sound. Now I heard there was a gang of niggas that don't like Eazy. That the motherfuckers janky down right low and dirty. I guess the pen is more quicker than the trigger. Don't be signing them contracts without reading them, nigga. Cause the industry is like no game. Always business, never personal, man. Yeah, Eazy has some scandalous ass days. But at times we all have motherfucking scandalous ways. But stop for a second. Think about the situation, G. If it wasn't no Eazy, it wouldn't be no VGs and no G's and gangsters expressing the fuck how they feel, what they desire. He opened up a can of worms to all riders, the true riders, and that's real.
It's for the E.
City G.
This is for the E.
crisis, realm of the queen. You know the routine, the flies of the moles on the scene. You know what I mean, I got a role, no other girl can portray. And if you wanna describe me, this is what you say. Sexy, devastating, awesome, impressive. Some girls are fresh, but Shantae's the freshest. So what you know, y'all bust the show. Pay attention, listen, watch the girl go. Another chapter, and I have to release another bomb as quick as I grab the MIC. Then I'll be straight, cause I'ma use the microphone as bait for other female MCs. So what you gonna do to this? You may be older than me, but you're new to this. Cause I've been out there, queen of MCs, when your man was walking around in mock necks and leaves. While you were over here perpetrating the fraud, I was overseas on a charge with Boy George. You're the beginner, Shantae's the winner. Have another competition for dinner. Sit you on the table with a plate and cup, say grace. And then eat your ass up. So step back, cuz I can hold my own. And everyone, y'all be easy, cuz this girl is gone.
Hey, it's Flashback Friday. That's my special guest, UTFO. Mixmaster Ice will be live on the premises coming up shortly. I'm taking you way back tonight. Call in 914-803-4001. You got a request, something you want to draw for me. I play, I'm talking, I talk back. Shout out to my homegirl, Yummy, out there. Tuned in. What up, Yum Yum? That's my girl right there. Shout out to Miss Jane as well. Hope you're feeling better. Somebody wanted me to send you a message.
Jane, it's Big Snoop Dogg. I'm here to let you know, don't you dare give up. Keep fighting. Your grandchildren need you. The world needs you. We never met in person, but you're the best person I know. So let's go. Keep fighting, Jane. Don't you dare stop. Snoop Dogg says so. Keep your head up and stay beautiful.
Shout out to Jane. Hey, this for my fly girls out there, man.
Fly girl, 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 fly This is Young Drew, a.k.a. Atlas and Smoke, affiliate of OG Music, and you're tuned in to the G-Lew Show.
Flashback Fridays. Hey, this one here is off the request line going out to my homeboys on the east side.
This is J.P. Banks.
Sticking to the script, it's a lonely road. So they left the hole and tanked the big homie toe. He know the way this testimony hold. On that L4, they gon' politic on him cold. SBI Bank EC for really though. Used to really go, ask my nigga Chili Mo. Had a cold gun game, crazy knuckle up. Bust some enemies with baby double up. Back and forth with the main streets on 98. Q97, me and Lil Johnny Ray. Posted up on Coden with a big ratchet. Way before Lil Wayne threw on that snitch jacket. Walked the yard with Slim Bag. What up, Big Drac? Gave them back they L, cuz you did that. Love my lokes, even if we don't interact. Lil Mont, Baby Psych, and Lil Black. EC. EC. 97th Street, smack dead in the Middle East. Fuck the police for King Ron Ron and Lil Reese. Tell the truth, SP3 never lack rhymes. Sometimes feel I might die behind my rap lines. We ain't in Malibu now, we in Maui. Baby Pie, EC, Bear, me and Wowie. Tico, Kiko, EC Red. Still can't believe Frankie and CC dead. Come to putting in work, did more than a little dirt. Airbrush shirt. Big Milk, Lil Merc, Lil Box, Baby Ant, Both Souls, all the coops. First Street to 24 when we call the troops. Lost the legend when we bury Bug. Coach love to the Riders that carry cuz. Never seen it coming. Was a little foul, still took heart though. My hat off to Lil Al. EC. EC. Spider both got an Ezel. Tiny Spider got 19. Rest in peace, Ezel. Shouts to the females representing EC. The brownies to the quotas. Rest in peace, TT. Big Tommy son on the 7, that's day pops. Me and mine never bowed down to J Box. And that's the coldest cripper nigga ever met. Coldest cripper ever heard about. Better yet, 33rd and every only time a nigga ran. On the land, go ask my nigga Ran. ECG unit came up a little show. Got told on by that nigga Lil Show. Went on TV, the homies did BT Ugly. Got love for Infinite and Lil EC Buzzy. For death though, that mean to my dying day. EC, that's all I've been trying to say. EC.
Shout out to the east side, my homeboy Spider Low. That's off the request line. Shout out to my boy Snow. Shout out to my sponsors, 93.3 FM Ism and BTP Media Group, my homeboy Jeff Kwan. He got it all. Coming up, UTFO, Mixmaster Ice, top of the hour. Let's smoke a stick, though.
On 4-7, the helicopter lights nearly blind me. In the southeast streets is where you might find me. True bandana, my scanner and my pager. In the blue 1994, one blazer. And I'm the one all the hoes wanna get with. Jack Daniels punch and the endo split. You don't like the way I kick shit, you can get the dick. 6-4-3 wheeling, mobbing to the picnic. But something's missing, wake up, I stop dreaming. Tashila, take a ride to the coast to get a demon. bring it back to Gompers Park, we bought two. And everybody knows what the fuck we gon' do. We gon' smoke a dip, all of it, not a little bit. We gon' smoke a dip. We gon' smoke a dip, all of it, not a little bit. We gon' smoke a dip. In the men's bathroom. Ooh, let me have room, make sure I light it right so it won't go boom. I took four hard hits and passed it to the next man. Now it seems like I got powers like the X-Man. Sitting on the curb for four fucking hours, dog. Thinking about my homie in the pen, little boss hog. Damn near dead, ready to head to the tilt. My homegirl woke me up with a carton of milk. I'm glad I didn't get caught slipping when I was sleeping on them fools from the other side. They call themselves creeping. But see, sucker, I'm from the Gangsta Nation crew. And everybody knows what the fuck we gon' do. We gon' smoke a dip, all of it, not a little bit. We gon' smoke a dip. We gon' smoke a dip, all of it, not a little bit. We gon' smoke a dip. Everybody that likes the fuck, throw your hands up. We gon' smoke a dip. Everybody that likes the fuck, throw your hands up, we gon' smoke a dip. I flipped the ill gangster shit on my worst day. Bitches saying, go bullet low, it's your birthday. My homie PK threw a party and I got there late. You know I had to make them hoes wait. And when I arrived, the whole shit was in a trance. Niggas getting bombed out, motherfucker dance. Getting ready for the next batch. My homies asshole naked doing the motherfucking cabbage patch. Niggas throwing up, it's a part of growing up. My piss test is straight, it ain't shit showing up. So duck, cause the next buster might be you. Now all y'all niggas know what my crew about to do. We gon' smoke a dip, all of it, not a little bit. We gon' smoke a dip. We gon' smoke a dip, all of it, not a little bit. We gon' smoke a dip. Everybody that likes the fuck, throw your hands up, we gon' smoke a dip. Everybody that likes the fuck, throw your hands up, we gon' smoke a dip. Yeah, it's for y'all niggas out there and y'all bitches out there smoking that water. Rest in peace, Big Trade All. Much love, love.
Yo, Kango.
Yeah, what's up, girl?
I'm the real Roxanne, and I rock your world.
But you're all stuck up.
Well, you say that, because I wouldn't give guys like you no rap. I was walking down the street in the afternoon. I gave you a smile, so you assumed that if you said hello, I wouldn't be flattered. But I kept walking, and your ego was shattered. I'm Roxanne, the Lady Devastator. I make it feel hotter than it is in Grenada. The R-O-X-A-N-N-E. Roxanne is who I be, and Kango King. You might be cute, but you ain't getting this because you're much too sweet. You wear that samurai sword on a tie. I told all my friends, and we all just died. I laughed so hard that my face turned blue. Why be an MC? You should learn Kung Fu. And by the way, if I'm such a crab, why all your girls look like gas? First you call me a peach. The doctor wants to take me to the beach. I got a little rhyme for you each. I seen your girls, they both need a leaf. Such bow wow babies. I think they got rabies. You think you touching me, boy, you must be crazy. You got your nerve to wanna be my man. They call me the real.
Can't you understand?
Be your man.
Now, educated rapper, I'ma give you a fit. Cause when you tried to talk to me, you was full of sh**. You see, the truth and the fact is that I don't need you. Your IQ is really 1.2. I don't like your rap cause your rap is dead. Educated rapper, no sense in your head. So when you met me, I paid you no mind. Dictionary breath, you're one of a kind. You said your name was Gary, didn't choose to call you Barry. Didn't care if your name was Mother Matter Harry. I choose to call you Sunny, because you have a tummy. My father's not a furry, you're the one who walks with Sunny. Your nose is always runny, you look like Buzz Bunny. All your raps are old, ancient as a mummy. Your house is so slummy, your clothes are so bummy. But now with your hit record, all I want is your money. Educated rapper, you ain't nothing but a dummy. You try to be chummy, or you play as Jim Rummy. I bet making love to you must really be crummy. You say it's customary to give your commentary. I say it's crap, it's full of strawberries. Your rap is so weak and your face is so scary. You always find a rap like yours in any cemetery. So do you know you didn't even pass? All you received was a kick in the ass. That's what you get, cause I had enough. And that right mix master ice cream puff.
Roxanne, Roxanne,
around the block. The Kango Kid and especially Doc would like to sleep with me if he can. But you're just a boy, you're not even a man. The girls know your name, it's getting around. Doc the Ice, you're the laugh of the town. You tried to throw a game, but it wasn't working out. You lied about the beach, you took me to your house. I said, me, the rock, give up the box so you can brag about it for the next 6 months. She, you must be crazy, you're going too fast. Doctor, I don't know where your hands been last. You can't fool me, cause down beneath, you're a hood, a crook, a liar, a thief. I know how you operate from the start. You like to break dance and you like to break on. So listen up, cause I don't say this every day. Oh girl, huh, he's out of doctor play. The only operating that you do is ripping off cars in a minute or two. You stole Larry Last Cadillac, stole it back and kept the hubcap. You are the one, you thought you had me wrong, but you hung yourself with your own stethoscope. You said, ooh, now what the hell was that? Your voice went high, now it sounds real whack. You called me at 9 to arrange a date. I said, meet me at the beach and don't be late.
But did you meet him at the beach?
Hell no, in the middle of December when it's 20 below, I'm the real.
Roxanne, Roxanne, I wanna be your man.
Our game plan.
Where's the beat? You guys can't deal it. I need a man who can make me feel it.
Yes, sir.
Yo, EMD.
Yeah, what's up, man?
They go that girl they call Roxanne. She's all stuck up.
Why you say that?
Cause you wouldn't give a guy like me no rap. Man, she was walking down the street, so I said, hello, I'm Kango from the U.T.F.O. And she so cool. Baby, don't you know I can sing rap dancing just one show? Cause I'm Kango, Mr. Sophisticator. As far as I know, ain't nobody greater from beginning to end and to beginning. I never knew because I'm all about winning. But if I was to lose, I wouldn't be safe. Cause I'm not a gambler, I don't bet. I don't be in no casino. And baby, why you nigga? The is the grizzly killing. You know, I thought you'd be impressed. Give me deep rap. I thought I had a joke, I was sending the trap. I thought it'd be a piece of joke, but it was nothing like that. I guess that's what I keep a thinking. Ain't that right, Black? Goodbye to Jesus. And see, nigga, I'm a wizard. Crispy with rockin' pizza of his ass. I can give him with a bang, bang, brother. I feel bad, but I ain't committing suicide for no crap. Calling her a crap is just a figure of speech. Cause she's an apple, a pear, a plum, and a peach. I thought I had it in the palm of my hand. But man, oh man, if I was grand, I'd bang Roxanne.
Roxanne, Roxanne,
can't you understand?
Roxanne, Roxanne,
I wanna be your man. Yo, Kango, I don't think that you're dense, but you went about the matter with no experience. You should know, she doesn't need a guy like you. She needs a guy like me with a high IQ. And she shakes for my raps, cause my raps the best. The educator back to MD will never fail. So when I met her, I wasted no time, but stuck up Roxanne, paid me no mind. She thought my name was Barry, I told her it was Gary. She said she didn't like it, so she chose to call me Barry. She said she loved to marry, my baby she would carry. And if she had a baby, his name's her baby Harry. Her mother's name is Baby, which is really quite contrary. Her face is very hairy, and you can say he's scary. She lives in Miami, her father's a fairy. His wife's secretary, his son's in the military. They forced him to enlist, I guess it wasn't voluntary. His daughter's name is Sherry, his son's a Tom and Jerry. Sherry had to prove it, it was only temporary. Back in January, or was it February? But every time I think it's fine, it makes me kind of weary. It's only customary to give this commentary. Some say it's bad, some say it's legendary. You're searching all you want to try your local library. You never find a rhyme like this in any dictionary. But do you know, after all that, all I received was a pat on my back. That's what you get, it happened to me. Ain't that right, Mixmaster, I-C-E. You had a rope, you thought you were Cupid. But EMD, your rap was plain stupid. I know you're educated, but what will you learn? Not all girls want to be involved with bookworms. You gotta be stronger when you can't resist. So educated rapper, huh, bust this. Since she's a new girl around the block, I had to let her know I was a debonair doc. I said I'd like to speak with you if I can. And if I'm correct, say your name is Roxanne. She said, how'd you know my father is getting around? Right now, baby, you're the talk of the town. She let me walk you to the corner. My rap will be brief. She said, I've seen you before. You
look like a thief, I said, me, the dot, a hood, a rock, run around and see the robbing people on the block, man, that's not my style, the crime I'm not related, it falls off the earth, I'm too sophisticated, then it seems I got to cause you cracked a smile, then let me know my rap was worth for a while, you said you call yourself a doctor, I said, listen to you, then explain to me really what doctors must do, I said, this is very simple, cause I don't say this every day, it's a major medical field, the doctor must wait. Dermatology is treatment of the skin. Infected and you see me over and over again. There's anesthesiology, ophthalmology, internal medicine, and plastic surgery, orthopedic surgery, and pathology. A disease could cause the change of the body. She said, ooh, that's very unique. Gave me her number and kissed me on her cheek. She said she had to go, but she'd be back by 8. Told me call at 9 to arrange a date. Did you take her to the beach? That's what we planned, but she stood me up. Roxanne, Roxanne. Game plan. The beat is here, so we will reveal it. And if you think it's soft, then Roxanne, feel it.
You back live with the G-Lew Show Flashback Friday. Got Mixmaster Ice, UTFO coming up shortly, right? Let me go to the phone lines right quick, though. Caller, hello.
Hey, Jay.
Hey, 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 what's up?
James. Not much.
What's up, Jay?
Thank you for playing
How you
that.
Going?
Thanks for playing
oh,
that.
Yeah.
That was quite a surprise getting that from Snoop Dogg.
Because you're special.
Yeah, that was funny.
That's right.
Yeah, yeah. But thank you so much and always appreciate all the spirit you give me. And that's my sis, Roxanne, Roxanne. Oh, my gosh. That took me back for real.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
I can't wait
yeah.
to hear from them.
Yeah, it's going down.
They got
yeah, it's going to be history tonight. We're going to talk some history. Take them back. Flashback Fridays. That's what we do.
That's right. That's right. All yep. right. Well, you have a good night.
Okay.
And, I'll be talking to you Sunday.
All righty, Jane. Thank you. Good evening.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Right.
Much love.
Much love back. Hey, it's the G-Lew Show, man. Hey, let me go to the phone lines. I got somebody from SD calling in.
G-Lew, what's going on with you?
Hey, what's up? What's up, Red? What's cracking?
Oh, man, I'm just checking in, man. Ain't that right, Mixmaster ICE? You know what I'm saying? That was, you know, Roxanne.
What you know about
that was
Island?
One of the first, man, that was one of the first raps that I learned how to do. Roxanne. Well, actually, that one, and then the one before that one was The Breaks by Curtis Blow, but Roxanne by UTFO, oh, man, that was the second song. I used to get my tape, you know, queued up because I used to tape it off of K-Day back in the days.
Right.
And I get my tape queued up, and you know how you try to stop it before the man start talking.
Right.
Yeah, man. So, you know,
that's crazy.
UTFO was my group, man. I'm grateful for, you know, I'm here always with you, man. I'm on this freeway, but I want to let you know I'm going to be right here, man. When you come back in, man, look out for me, man. You know, I know, do your interview. I might hang up and call back so I can hit the one again, you know, but I'm with you,
okay.
G-Lew.
My man.
Then
appreciate
don't worry,
you,
man.
Ali.
I'm
much love.
I got the verse with Cam where I just had to look for it because, you know, I be hiding my music from everybody, even myself sometimes. So, you know,
right,
I got to go.
Okay.
But I found it, and I'm going to send you that so you can hear his verse and then go whatever, you know, if you want to change something, do your thing, go ahead and do it, man. And then I'm going to go on and put it in that studio, man, on the SSL board and mix it, man.
That part. Okay, Ali, I'll be looking for that on my desk, man.
Yes, sir. I'm right here with you, though, man. I'll be right here.
Okay, for sure. Much love, Ali.
I love you, man. Much love. God bless you.
Love you back, bro. Flashback Friday, the G-Lew Show, 914-803-4001. Mixmaster Ice, UTFO coming up.
Thank you.
also go to YouTube and check us out on our YouTube channel, the G-Lew Show. Show some love. Shout out to Flossie, Lee, Norman, Malik, Spellman, G-Lo. Shout out to Mega Listen. What's up, baby? Shout out to G-Lew. Hold up, let me do it like this.
Yo, don't give him nothing but a microphone. Don't stop, I'm not finished yet. You said I'm not the E. You wanna make a bet, remember this? Lounge, you in the danger zone. I figured you would, now leave me alone. You pick and you wish on the four-leaf clover to be the E-double-E. Over and over, you intrigued by the way I do my thing.
Do what?
Pick up the mic, high, and make a swing.
I have the capability to rap and chill. Coax attacks MCs who tend to act ill. It's like a signal smack. Smack me and I'll smack your back. I get goosebumps when the bassline thumps to suck an MC on ride. Now it's time for lunch. When I'm cooling on the scene, I notice one thing, I'm not bound. So suck an MC's clean. I consider myself better than average. Yo, I rock the mic like a wild beast savage.
I'm in the bottom state, I can't concentrate. I make a move like chess, then I yell checkmate. You know why I get Xania and Xania? Because of the PMD main. And when I walk through the crowd, I can see heads turning. I hear voices saying that's Eric Sermon. Not only from the women, but from the men. You know what, it feels good, my friend.
I'm the P-double-E, the thriller of Manila. Better known as the MC Cold Killer. PMD's goal is to keep the place jumping. And if not, we feel we owe you something. It's like Lotto, you have to be in it to win it. But if the beat is fresh, then Diamond J will spin it. J's spinning, it has to be deaf to make you dance until there's no one left.
Cause you a customer.
When the fox in action, I smell blood, no time for maxing. Camouflage in the green, my back is arc. Plus you in trouble cause it's after dark. My eyes closed like Steve Austin, I got you in the square. I will let you run, nah, that ain't fair. So I clear my vision so I can spot him, snatch him up by the neck. I said, I got him. By now MCs, you're in over your head. My rhymes are hungry but they haven't been fed. The process of elimination's quite simple. Let you grow like a blackhead and pop you like a pimple. Slice you like lettuce, toss you like a salad. Revoke your MC license if your rhyme's invalid. As we go on, sucker MC sound whacker. Like a parrot and Polly wants a cracker.
There was a rap contest, nothing we can handle. At a house that had the mics on the mantle. Looked at the DJ and said, may I? Lit it up like the 4th of July. Because I float like a butterfly, sing like a bee. No, I'm the E of EP. PMD. I have a strong point of view on the way things run. Just shut up and listen and learn, my son.
Absorb that ass like bounty. The quicker picker up, I tell you up front. You're nothing but a sucker. The style we're using, no doubt, copacetic. You try to bite and yet sound pathetic. Design my rhymes like a tailor. Floating like a sailor as the peak gets stronger. MC gets stellar, not bragging off the tagging. Surely not fagging. MC surrender. Raise the flags and give up the titles, but the signs are vital. I keep the voice tuned at a slow and swift idle.
Are you a customer?
Get down, get down.
I need a man meal sandwich, yes, I need manwich. I feel good now, it's time to do damage. I feel like battling, you know what I mean? One around, one time to release the steam. When I got the mic, I get your mic like an actor. You know why I get over, I'm the master. I do a show pack, I then two is clamming up. Look for the microphone, then I jam it up.
He said you see me jamming at New York Tech. You got one right, fella, you deserve a check. How did you know? You must have been jogging. How would you know? The places I be rocking. Don't follow me, fella. Every move that I make. I'm hostile now, so I give you a break. Research upon me, but don't go past the limit. Here's my card and on the back is my fan club digits.
There's two things to check out the words that I'm saying.
plus listen to the good top playing. The boy is bad. The strings he's plucking. Fire rhyme after rhyme. Watch MC ducking.
MCs, it's the final countdown. You look tight. Can you go around? If you can, I'll slap your hand and give you credit. And if not, I turn around and say forget it.
Forget
what they say, that I'm a party pooper. That's not true, I'm a born out of pooper.
You a customer.
You a customer.
You a customer.
Boy, Wang.
That's just you.
Yo, we out of here like that, yeah.
Flashback Fridays, man. What would life be without Too Short, man? Shout out to Short Dog. Shout out to the Bay. I've been having a lot of people on my show on Westside Wednesdays from the Bay all month, last month, this month. We got some more Bay area artists coming up trying to show some love because it's Westside Wednesday. So tune in to Westside Wednesdays. Get caught up. We had RVL Posse, AMW, Delinquent, Gang of Mo people, man. We got Richie Rich coming up. Spice One is coming back. We got some other surprises, man, so be on the lookout for Westside Wednesdays. But it's Flashback Friday tonight, and we got my special guest, Mixmaster Ice, UTFO, coming up in a minute. Call in once again, 914-803-4001. If you want to talk to the homie when he checks in, ask him some questions, or if you got a request.
You're cold, Flashback Friday. Be with me.
The light so I can see reality. action. Against all relaxing, prepare for steady waxing. When you leave, you must be eat for what satisfaction.
Hey girl, you wanna be with me? Because I need someone to be with, someone to talk to. You cold, wanna be with me? Because you need someone to be with, someone to talk to.
A lot of these girls trying to play the role. Every time I see them, they're on the stroll. Teasing the fellas, wearing tight pants, leading us on after a slow dance. But in search of love, that's how I'm living. I want a girl to give me the same thing that I am giving to her. From now till the day I depart, well, she's got to be a red bone, a beautiful work of art. That is the way this Pisces feels like C.C. Williams on the Eyewitness News. I hate a girl that knows every guy. Before you introduce, he already says hi. I feel like punching a dead in the grill, but that's ill. So doctor, still, cause if it's meant to happen, that's how it'll be. Sooner or later, you'll co-be with me. She wants to be with me, and I know this for sure. I could tell as soon as she walks through the door. Swings and sways and shakes the stuff like jello. Waiting for EMD to say hello. Keep tight clothing, with everything hanging. And all the boys admit that you're well worth banging. She only talks to talk, never walks to walk. She must be the most hot up in all New York. Like an angel, pretends to keep the face. At least that's a pretty picture, she will up the pace. She's extraordinary, definitely rare. And anywhere you want me, baby, I'll be there. I'll make you feel content, fill you with bliss. Send a finger through your body with just one kiss. But if you don't show, I won't be stunned. Give your mother my number, I know she'll come.
Hey girl, you wanna be with me? Because I need someone to be with, someone to talk to. You don't wanna be with me because you need someone to be with, someone to talk to.
I want a girl that'll turn me on. When I say go, I wanna hear her say gone. When I say leave, I wanna hear her say left. And if I say was it good, she better say death. Cause that's the kind of girl that I am looking for. I really don't think there are any more. But if one appears one day, I walk up to her and gently say, I've been staring at you a while. And every time you see me staring, you crack a smile. Nicole wanna be with me, it's true. If you didn't, I wouldn't be next to you.
So please stop further tracing. Girl, I'm tired of wasting.
You hurry up and make the so-called move that you've been talking about making girls show and prove. There's really no need to talk about it. You know what I want, so what about it? We can either go fast or slow, cause I'll be in and out before you know. Girl, here's a spot you missed. So cold.
Hey girl, you wanna be with me? Because I need someone to be with, someone to talk to. You cold wanna be with me? We call a whistle, and this is true. We love to do the things that we're not supposed to do. We don't need robbing, stealing, or mugging. In fact, we'll take it seriously. We're only bugging. Out.
before a whistle, and this is true. We love to do the things that we're not supposed to do. We don't mean robbing, stealing, or mugging. In fact, don't take it seriously. We're only bugging. Well, it's all about us, Jazz the KC. But sometimes it's all about just me. You know what I notice all of a sudden? When I see people this ear button, there's not another person who sounds like me. Intuitively, there will never be. I'll say a tongue twister like the blink of an eye. Say it so well, you would think it's a lie. Like Peter Parker picked up his gold pen, put it on the fast tail, then pursued his friend. His plot deployed, the polluted punk persisted to prohibit, so the plot is bland flunk. My problem with pleasure, pleasure people who sleep is blame. The problem part without a picture of grief. And my present plague procrastinates my plea. So I'm the perfect face, make a perpetrator praise me.
Tell me, girl, now is it true that you love for me just to talk to you? For you to be my girl and I'll be your man. You'd be mine, not just another fan. You'd be with me everywhere I go. You'd hold my hand at every show. Inseparable is what we'd be. Jazz and jazz and eternally. But after all of this, you know the dream would end. I wouldn't talk to you, I'd talk to your friends. And you would call me conceited and you'd call me wrong. But you'd call me that night and try to turn me on. You'd dial my digits in the day and late at night. Promise and swear that you'd do me right. But I doubt that anything that you do would ever give me the stomach to talk to you. Now I'm bugging.
Hey, Flashback Fridays. Before I continue on, I want to say rest in peace to the late, great Bushwick Bill, the legendary Bushwick Bill from the Ghetto Boys. Passed away earlier this week from cancer. It's taken out a lot of us. Take better care of yourself. Get your health together. Health is wealth. But I want to say rest in peace to Bushwick, man. You did it real big for a little guy, man. Rest in peace, bro. Flashback Fridays.
Our society.
Paranoid, sitting in a deep sweat, thinking I gotta fuck somebody before the week ends. A sight of blood excites me, shoot you in the head, sit down and watch you bleed to death. I hear the sound of your last breath, shouldn't have been around, I went all the way left. You was in the right place for me at the wrong time. I'm a psychopath, in a minute lose my fucking mind. Calm down, back to reality, don't fit this, cause I know that it promised me flashes. I get flashes of Jason. A minute lives I'm wasting. The shadow of death follows Bill. I don't give a fuck. Pussy play Superman. Your ass will get boxed up. Put him in a straitjacket. The man's sick. This is what goes on in the mind of a lunatic.
He's a paranoid who's a menace to our society. He's a paranoid who's a menace to our society.
Looking through a window. Now my body is warm. She's naked. And I'm a piece of time. Her body's beautiful, so I'm thinking rape. Shouldn't have had her curtains open, see that's a fake. Leaving out her house, grabbed the bitch by her mouth. Drug her back in, slam her down on the couch. Without my knife, did it be scream I'm cutting. Open her legs, they commence to fucking. She begged in a low voice, please don't kill me. I slit her throat and watch her shake like on TV. Now there's a witness, all in my business. Sitting with a bloody body next to me, I'm nervous. Now the time has come for me to make a decision. Should I live in reality or live in the television? Here come the cops, will they blow me to bits? This is what goes on in the mind of a lunatic.
Another innocent victim.
Yo, Bushwick, what do you do when motherfuckers underestimate your size, man?
First of all, I lied.
Then what?
Smash their ass like a goddamn car crash. So if you wanna try your luck, come on. Play pussy, get fucked. Asshole, sneaky, get beat. You're a bad motherfucker if you dare to compete. Cause Diana Ross will be coming out your ass, fool. And have you singing the blues? Tall or bigger by the power, let's go around. I'ma take you, shake you, and break you down. And if you kick, I'ma pick up a stick and beat your ass to the size of your dick, and that's more. And you think you're macking while you lacking? Bushwick is packing. I'll show your girl how a real man feels. Large things come in very small packages. And while you're getting on your knees to fuck, a nigga like me still standing up. Any bitch will tell ya, as long as he has a big dick, size ain't shit.
Yo, Bushwick Bill, man, show these hoe-ass motherfuckers out here in the game, man, that you're too short to take a motherfucking short. And DJ Ready Red got your motherfucking back.
Lifting weights will make you bigger, but lift me, you'll be a dead-ass nigga. You wanna squabble cause you think you're tougher? Squabble that, motherfucker. Those are called bullets, they got them in every state to keep niggas like you in place. And since I'm a
have it. Nah, 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 nah. Any motherfucker wanna get with Bushwick? Bring it on, cause your size ain't shit.
It used to be fun, but now it's getting boring to me. Constantly fucking, 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 fucking. Ride my dick like a horse, fucking, fucking. Now I'm needing that enlightenment in my life. I'm missing that excitement. Thinking about how these two girls could excite me. Then it hit me, both of them like me. Yeah, that's the lick. Listen and learn while I kick the more serious shit.
Hey, once again, rest in peace to the homeboy Bushwick, Bill. Shout out to my homeboy Jeff Kwan from BTP Media Group. He's going to be coming up in a minute, bringing my guest to the stage. Mixmaster Ice, UTFO. What up, everybody tuning in with me? It's the G-Lew Show Flashback Friday. Hope you're enjoying your Friday. Smoking something good, drinking something good. Listening to me, because I'm listening to you. Let's get in traffic.
Checking out the scene on my CB, cause I don't want no bears fucking with me. That's a big 10-4, good buddy. Yeah. Smoking weed, feeling fine, when suddenly I see a blue light behind. Call a dickhead, check out my crack. Think I got a bear on the bank. He's on my ass, and that's no joke, but I'm gonna leave that blue light motherfucker in the smoke. 10-4.
Again.
come on, boy, let's have a drink. Those rednecks in the corner start getting up out of their seats, carrying big clubs, wearing white sheets. He said, listen, nigga man, I'm the grand dragon for the Ku Klux Klan. He said, there's no nigga better than me. Motherfuck you and Muhammad Ali. I threw my drink in his face and I started to run as I felt the lead from his shotgun. I got in my rig and covered up my face and I drove my truck through that motherfucking place. Hoes started to run, it was glass in the hair and crackers' ass was flying everywhere. The grand dragon was on the ground with his ass bloody and I looked at him, I said, 10-4, good buddy. Yeah. I reached in the seat and grabbed a bottle of wine and I looked in the mirror and said, I can't stand myself sometimes. And then I said, ooh.
Well, I'm not into surgery, I'm not into books, and I may look the way that you imagine. watching, I look, but I'm looking good, baby. And you best believe that too. When it said Jago, they meant the hat. Now when they said Sticky, they meant me, of course. When it said U.T.F.O, they meant I've done it before. And the way I perform, I ought to be sued, cause I specialize in being nothing but rude. The leaders of the pack are the one in command. Comprende, capisce, capon, understand.
Yo. What's this?
Yo.
What's this?
Indigenous land, I'll discombobulate any rapper I can. My superior vernacular will keep me ahead. Most of you are cogitating what I just said. Intellectual verses like this are hard to find. The elementary are always a pain. Interesting literature is good for your brain. And if I was a Mexican, I'd wear a sombrero. If I was a soldier, I'd probably be a hero. But I'm not, I'm into rap, and I'm down with the ninja.
Mixmaster, I. Mixmaster, I. Mixmaster, I.
Did you like that, huh?
Yeah!
Hand out a cigar. I'm letting knowledge be born, and my name's the R. AKA, I am not like the rest of them. I'm not on the list. Catch what I'm saying? I drop lines like a scientist. My melodies in the cold. The very next episode has the mic off and distorting, ready to explode. I keep the mic at Fahrenheit. Freedom's easy to make them cola. The listener's system is kicking like solar. As I memorize, advertise like a poet. Keep you going when the flow is smooth enough. You know it's a rough. That's why the mural on my story, I tell a B. Nobody beats the R. Check out my melody. Microphone fiend addicted soon as I seen one of these forms, so they don't have to scream. I couldn't wait to take the mic, blow into it to test it, let my melody play. Then a record suggested I'm dropping bombs, but I say peace and calm. Any MC that disagree with me, wave your arm. And I'll break when I'm awake, and I'll leave you broke. Drop the mic when I'm finished and watch it smoke. So stand back, you wanna rap all the back and wait. I won't push, I won't beat around the bush. I wanna break upon those who are not supposed to. You might try, but you can't get close to. Because I'm number one, competition is none. I measure with the heat that's made by sun. Whether playing ball or bobbing in the hall, or just writing my name in graffiti on the wall. They shouldn't have told me, you said you control me. So now a contest is what you owe me. Pull out your money, pull out your cut, pull up a chair. My name is Rockin' My Law, and all my A's and Barras, switch it around. It still comes out all so easily. Will I E-M-C-E-E? My repetition of words, just check out my melodies. I'm making treble is moist, scratching and cutting a voice. And when it's mine, that's when the rhyme is always choice. I wouldn't have came and set my name and run the same week. Putting blurs and slurs and words that don't fit in a rhyme. Why waste time on the microphone? I take this more serious than just a poem. Rock from party to party, backyard to yard. I tear it up, y'all, and bless the mic of the God. Rhyme is rugged at the same time, sharp. I can swing off anything, even the swing of a harp. Just turn it on and start rocking. Mine, no introduction. Till I finish dropping signs, no interruption. When I approach, I exercise like a coach. Using a melody and add numerous to notes. So in the mic, in the R-A-K-I-M, it's attached like a match. I was right again. Rhymes are poetically kept in alphabetic steps. Put in an order to proceed with the momentum except. I say one rhyme out of order, a longer rhyme, shorter, or pause. But don't stop, just take recording. Come on.
Check out my melody. 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 Check out my melody.
Hey, shout out to my homeboy Big D out there, homie. Welcome home, bro.
Editor, melody arranger, poet, etc. Extra events, the grand finale like bonus. I am the man they call the microphonist with wisdom, which means wise words being spoken. Too many at one time, watch the mic start smoking. I came to express the rap I manifest, and in my way, and I'll be the other words protest. MCs that wanna be bitch, they're gonna be this if they don't get from in front of. All they can go get is me, a glass of Moet. A hard time, sip your juice and watch a smooth poet. I take seven MCs, put them in a line, and add seven more brothers who think they can rhyme. Well, it'll take seven more before I go for mine. Now that's 21 MCs, eight up at the same time. Easy does it, do it easy, that's what I'm doing. No fessing, no messing around, no chewing, no robbing or buying. Biting, why bottle? This lava stop trying, fighting to follow my unusual style. Will confuse you a while. If I was water, I'd throw in denial. So many rhymes, you won't have time to go for yours. Just because of a pause, I have to pause. Right after tonight is when I prepare to get another sucker duck MC out there. Cause my strategy has to be tragedy, catastrophe. And after this, you'll call me your majesty, my melody. Yes, yeah, my melody. Eric D. Synthesized it, I memorized it. Eric B made a cut and advertised it. My melodies created for him, he's in the place. You try to listen, cause I'm different, then so pick up your face. Took off your necklace, you try to detect my pace. Now you're drugging, almost drugging off my rhyme like bass. The melody that I'm styling, smooth as a violin. Rough enough to break New York from Long Island. My wisdom is swift, no matter if my momentum is slow. MCs still stand still from genuine like leather. Decline to be clever, MCs defeat the R, I'll say, oh never. So B, cut it easily and check out my melody.
Good evening. I'm very proud of you. As you all know, I grew up in the South during Jim Crow, lived through segregation, I lived through integration. We moved to Los Angeles to have a better life and found that things were very similar there as they were down South. So as a mother of three boys, who tried to raise them on my own. Wasn't perfect, but I could, and I'm proud of my son, and I just want to say I love Louis, and thank you for doing the show, and keep doing what you're doing. People need to hear this.
I mean, Rookie, what's up, baby? Oh, man, I'm just smoking on the moon, man, I heard they had apartments up here, so I had to come here and get some of this good old-fashioned green.
That part, man. Hey, we just want to salute to you, man, and all you've done, man, for the culture and everything, man. It's an honor to have you, you know, right here on the phone with us right now. Much love to you, Corrupt, Young Gotti. Respect, homie.
Well, thank you very much. I got more for you now.
I know you do, boy.
You
got a whole
lot.
What could we expect next, Corrupt, man? What we got coming up, man?
Got that new Dog Pound album, me and Daz and Snoopy. I got that new Corrupt solo album that Fred Records produces, and Daz, Dr. Dre on it as well, Pete Rock. You know what I'm saying? I'm hitting them with these moon rocks. I'm hitting them with this film. I mean, I'm all over the place right now.
Hey, I know it, man. Also, I want to congratulate you on the moon rocks, man. You know, coming into that game and it taking it to a whole other level. That's the top of the... That's the top shelf right there, Moon Rock, man. You did that, homie. Congratulations on that.
Well, you know, man, I'm just trying to supply these patients correctly. You know, I'm also trying to, now that it's legal in Los Angeles, we can supply the streets. So it's a great thing,
right.
You know what I'm saying, man? And it's good. I don't know too many people right. that crashed off of smoking some good bomb, man.
That part.
I can't speak on alcohol, but I know when they offer that bomb, everybody's driving slow.
That part, man. That part.
Everybody's cruising, man. They Smokey Robinson on that.
That part, man. Hey, much love to you, Corrupt Salute, man. Thank you, man, for joining us, man.
Oh, man, thanks for having me, and you do know that. Y'all be good,
that part,
man.
You know that. And you do know that. It's the G-Lew Show Flashback Fridays. I'm still waiting on the homie Mixmaster Ice, UTFO. My homie Jeff let me know that it should be coming soon. I'm waiting like you, so don't trip. It's a live show. You know what I mean? You know artists are late sometimes, and he probably doing his thing, so we're just going to wait on the homie. Uh-oh. We might have him now. Let me go to the phone line. Hello.
You are.
There he is. There he is, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes, indeed.
You the legendary, are. The legend, Mixmaster Ice.
What's it doing, man? How's everything going, everybody? What's up with you, boy?
Hey, man, it's all good, loved one. Thank you for checking in with us, man. I was just telling the people, man, I said we're still waiting on him, man. He'll probably be checking in shortly, but, you know, I know how it is,
yeah,
man. But
finished,
thank you, bro.
I just got finished doing it. Thank you, too, man. I just got finished doing a set. So, you know, I mean, I'm all good right now. But I appreciate the patience, everyone. Truly, truly appreciate it.
Right. So, Ice, man, tell him, man, you know, I've been telling them, I've been playing the music. Everybody knows you go way back. You know what I mean? The 80s, you know what I mean? And you're still doing it now. Let us know, first of all, what's been going on with you, fam? Like, what you've been doing? I see you busy. Let the people know what you do and what you did and what you still do to this day.
All right. Well, this is the legendary Hall of Fame DJ Mixmaster Ice from UTFO. And just constantly just staying busy, you know, always trying to stay relevant in the game. I DJ all over the place, still DJ, never stop DJing. And next year is actually my 40th DJ anniversary. So there's a lot of things that's in tune for that, man, putting together world tours and a lot of traveling and doing a lot of engagements and stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? It's a blessing to still be around and be able to do what I love and love to do what I do. You feel me? So, you know, I just appreciate all the support throughout all the years for myself. And all the support that came to UTFO, you know, all the people that helped pave the way before us. But, you know,
right.
to all our fans and people that still support me, man, I appreciate and have nothing but the utmost love for everyone, man.
Right. I also want to ask you, Ice, man, being that you come from the era where it was all about the DJ, you know what I mean? The DJ was the main, you know, the main important tool to the group. You know what I mean? It was the DJ first because he let the rappers rap. You know, tell us what do you think about as far as today how the music scene has changed to where, you know, it's DJs out there that do, but as far as in the music and how it was back in the day, what do you feel about where DJing has come to today opposed to when you started?
Well, it definitely has been a shift since the early development of hip-hop. The DJ was the man. The DJ was the one-man band. You know, the DJ replaced the band. The DJ is the one that kept the music going. It kept the party going. In fact, there is no party without a DJ. That's the main ingredient. That's the main element. There's no party you can have without a DJ. You have to have music to have a party. The DJ, you know, I remember so far back where you couldn't even get near the DJ. Like, that's how infamous he was. It was like he was roped off. You couldn't even get near him. Like, you could get to the MC, because they was all in the front line. And you could get to the breakdancers, but you definitely could not get to the DJ. DJ was roped off.
Hey, Ice.
Doing his thing.
And you definitely could not touch those tables unless it would be a beatdown.
You ain't even gonna get near it. You can't even get near the DJ unless you super juice. But yeah, you walk up touching the you're gonna catch a bad one because it's gonna be rough for you.
Just to finish up,
the DJ, you know, the shift has been to where now in certain situations the DJ is almost obsolete. You know, it's like you got a lot of MCs system. Let me give you an example. Back then, when you thought of Run DMC, you thought about Jam Master J. When you thought about Houdini, you thought about Grandmaster D. When you thought about W Fresh, you thought about Chill Will and Barry B, the Get Fresh crew. When you thought about UTFO, you thought about Mixmaster Ice. When you thought about LL, you thought about Cut Creator. You know, I can go on and on and on with those type of combinations where the DJs were very significant.
Eric B, Rakim.
Now,
Eric B was first.
Eric B and Rakim. We can keep going on and on and on with that era. Now, let's fast forward all the way to now. If I ask the average person who's Lil Wayne DJ, they're going to be stuck. If I ask the average person who's Young Jeezy DJ, they're going to be stuck. If I ask them who's Tiger DJ, they're going to be stuck. Who else is hot right now? Drake. Who's Drake DJ? J. Cole. Who's J. Cole's DJ? Who else is hot right now in the game?
Whoever you can name. You can't name the DJ behind him.
The Migos. Who is the DJ for the Migos? And go on and on and on. The bottom line is back then the DJ was very relevant and the name meant something. You had some respect on that name. Now, and I'm not saying that these guys, these people I'm naming don't have DJs because I'm sure they do have DJs.
They just probably have them for hire.
Who are their DJs?
They just DJs for hire.
Yeah, but who are their DJs? The names aren't significant like how it was back when we were. So yes, the pendulum has shifted, and for whatever reason, the DJ isn't respected on that level like he used to be.
Right.
You don't even hear
scratches
in the songs anymore like you used to hear them.
Yeah, they don't do that. Yeah, they don't do that. Like
you
I was
hear
saying,
that?
DJ is obsolete. The DJ is really just program beats and what they do with the the new technology, the Pro Tools and the beat machines. So the DJ is obsolete. But on the flip side, I know a lot of DJs progress to producing because since they already knew the music, so that was kind of good. But like we say, there's no more DJ, which used to make the group happen. You know what I mean?
It still exists. Yeah, it still exists and it's still there. But on a major scale, it's nothing like how it used to be. You name any of those hip-hop groups from the 80s, and you knew who their DJ was. You name anybody from this era, and you'd be lucky if you could figure out one group's DJ.
Right. Hey, Ice.
You know what I'm
speaking
saying?
Speaking on that, like you said back in the day, before I ask you that, I want to ask you, how was it, like you said, it was hard to be a DJ, and you had to be really dope. How was it like coming up in your era to make it to where you're a major DJ for a major group? Because I'm sure there was plenty of DJs in line. How does a DJ go about getting to that point back in the day?
So back then, first of all, we used all vinyl. There was no technology. The technology was our hands. And we carried those crates. And you was as good and as deep as your crates were. It took a lot of practice. I started DJing in 1980. By 1984, y'all heard me perform on that Roxanne record. Okay, and then the rest was history after that. But that was 4 years of a lot of practicing, cutting school, getting in trouble, doing all kind of stuff, just because all I wanted to do was practice. And by the time I was 19, which was in 84, that's when we made the Roxanne record. Then shortly after that, we did our first album, and the leading single off the album was Leader of the Pack, which was a song featuring me.
Yeah.
Leader of the Pack. The man in the back is dressed in black. He's called what we call the Leader of the Pack. That record's about me. That's my DJ record. You understand what I'm saying? So, you know, nowadays there's a lot of gadgets. There's a lot of technology, you know, which is a curse and a blessing. But you got little kids DJing. Anybody can DJ now because anybody can get a controller, get a laptop full of songs, and be able to manipulate the songs according to how the software works. So
there are
still some DJs that still operate the turntables, but a lot of people now are caught up in the technology because they're not pressing records anymore. So you're almost forced to use technology. Even with the turntables now, you have to cross bridge it with technology. You know what I mean? Because they're not pressing the vinyl. So if you want to play new material, you have to play the digital version of it. And the digital version is going to be an MP3.
Right. Do you still play vinyl at your sets?
If I don't play vinyl with my, well, yeah, when I'm on the turntables, yes. But to bring in vinyl, to bring in the old school records, I only do that if it's an old school event and that's what the promoter wants. So every now and then I still get booked for those type of events. But I also get booked for a lot of, you know, events where they want to hear the new music mixed with some of the old, a little bit of both. But if I'm doing this straight old school set and they want me to rock just the vinyl, I can do an all vinyl set. But I don't do a lot of all vinyl sets because I don't get booked for that often. But I can do it.
Right. Also, I want to ask you.
I prefer to do it. I prefer vinyl myself.
Right. Because that's what you do. But I want to ask you as well.
Yeah.
How is it for a DJ such as yourself these days? Like you're saying, you're still getting booked. Do you get booked for more old school sets, or how do you mix it up? And how do you, when you do a party or a set where you do the new music, how are you equipped to do that? Like, are you hip with everything? I'm sure you have to be. But how do you mix that up, and what do you prefer better?
I work hard. I say, listen, the hardest part of the game for me is staying relevant because this music is coming out so fast at warp speed. 1 minute the song is here, a month later that song is gone and done. So you got to, and then it's new artists popping in and out real quick, in and out. But to answer your question, I really just study the game. I'm still a fan of the game. Of course, I've mastered the old school. You know what I mean? I come from that era. But as far as what's going on now, I studied. I watched the charts. I'm still in link with the record companies. They still send me the music. And I still get booked for a lot of 25 and over and 30 and over. Even 25 and over is young. 30 and over is young. You know what I'm saying? 30 and over is young. A person 30 years old is young in hip-hop. You know, they party into the young music. You know, I'm in my 50s. You know what I'm saying? So... You know, just basically to answer your question, I just really work hard at staying relevant. You know, so I get booked for old school events, and I get booked for some of the current stuff too. You know what I'm saying? But my name really represents and resonates when it comes to them throwbacks. I get to them really thorough with them throwbacks because that's where I come from. But because I stay relevant and I study the game, I keep up to par with all the new music too.
Right. And do you get around the country a lot, or do you do a lot of stuff in New York, or do you get about a lot around the country?
Yeah, I travel a lot, man. I currently live in Ohio right now, and I got a gig coming up. I'll be doing I'm DJing in New York in the first week in August.
Okay.
I'll be back home and DJing. This gig is in the Bronx. I'm from Brooklyn, but I'll be DJing at Katona Park in the Bronx. So the Tools of War Park Jam, they bring out a lot of legends for that. So I've been invited back to rock the park this year again. I travel. I got North Carolina. I got North Carolina in 2 weeks. I'll be DJing at the Black Enterprise Expo out there. I move around a lot, man. I got Milwaukee coming up the first weekend, the first Saturday in August. I'll be in Milwaukee. But to make a long story short, I still travel, still, you know, move around all over the place. Next year will be my 40th anniversary, so with God's blessing, I'll be able to put together a world tour and do some international dates.
Wow. Okay. That's what's up. For the people wanted me to ask you some questions, but I want to ask you first, take us back a bit. How did the group UTFO, I know a couple of the homies were dancers and came up with Houdini, but how did the whole group form and what was the basis around the group, you know, when it formed, and how did everything kick off with UTFO for you?
Okay, I'll try to give you a short version because I know we on air. Short version would be this: myself and the Educated Rapper, we started off together around 1980. We had a DJ crew. The crew was called Jam-A-Lot Crew, and it consisted of myself. At the time, my name was DJ Ice. I didn't even have the Mixmaster yet. It was DJ Ice. And Jeff, rest in peace, the Educated Rapper, rest in peace, EMD. His name at the time used to be Special J. His first name was Jeff, so he went by the name Special J at first. And we had a DJ crew called the Jam-A-Lot Crew, consisting of me, him, a couple of other guys in the neighborhood. Kango and Doc used to be breakdancers, and Kango also rapped too. We was having auditions for our DJ group because we wanted to try to transition into a rap group. So we was auditioning for some rappers. And Kango was one of the guys that came to the audition, and he had Doc with him. I don't even think Doc rhymed at that time. So Kango came to the audition, and at some aspect of the audition, instead of it being an audition, Kango and EMD was going to end up battling on the microphone. But they never ended up battling, and what ended up happening was we ended up forming a group out of that whole situation of having that audition. And
right. We
transitioned into the group, into the name Untouchable Force Organization. Mm. At that time, I actually used to rap a little bit back then, too, because me and EMD used to be on the microphone in our DJ group. But when we transitioned into the rap group, Kango and EMD became main MCs, and Doc started writing rhymes. So Doc started catching up and writing rhymes. I fell all the way back and just focused more on the DJ. And to make the long story short, Kango and Doc also won some breakdancing contests, which in New York, which ultimately led them to be able to dance for Houdini. Kango and Doc was actually the first group to dance for a rap group, which was Houdini. They were the first breakers to dance for a rap group. So they did that for, they went on tour with Houdini off their first album. And when Doc and Kane came back, Full Force signed us, and then we got signed to Select Records, and then Full Force took us in the studio, did Beats and Rhymes, did the Roxanne record. Then from the Roxanne record, we got an album deal, and then from the album deal, you know, we ended up doing four records with Select Records and one album with Dive Records. But like I said, this is the speeded up version. You know what I mean? We were from East Flatbush, Brooklyn. We were just out there, you know, just a neighborhood battle group. You know, we was a battle group. Everybody battled back then. So we was a battle group from East Flatbush. And the name was Untouchable Force Organization. The original spelling for the name was UFO. Because of contractual reasons, we couldn't use the name UFO because somebody already had that license in Europe. So we had to change the name, but we kept the meaning the same, which was Untouchable Force Organization. We switched the letters and made it UTFO. So that's how the T got in there, Untouchable Force Organization.
Okay. That's the speeded up version of Mixmaster Rice.
We started off in the neighborhood. We met Full Force. We ended up making some records. Hey, records blew up.
That's what.
Next thing you know, we're
Hold up, Ice. I didn't mean to cut you off. Let me ask you this: What importance? Let the people know what importance and significance Full Force had, because a lot of people, you know, they just know them from the few songs they had in the house party.
Okay.
But a lot of people don't know the importance Full Force had on hip hop. So could you break that down since you spoke on Full Force?
Yes, indeed. Full Force, if not the first, is truly one of the first hip hop bands. Well, they really are. They really were the R&B and funk band, but they also, you know, Full Force is so talented. They can do it all. So, you know, from a hip hop perspective, they're one of our first hip hop bands. But I don't want to categorize Full Force as a hip hop band because they really are so deeply rooted with the R&B. But Full Force was our first. Was our producers. We were their first rap group and first big hit record. They signed us. After us, they had Lisa. Cheryl Pepsi Rally, the Real Rock Fan was signed to Full Force Productions, and Full Force themselves was releasing themselves as artists on major record labels, also producing themselves. So they were highly responsible. They produced the Roxanne records for starters. You know, they produced most of our whole entire career until we started, you know, doing some things on our own. Full Force held a lot of our early hits down, and as well as Lisa. As well as the Real Rock Fan, they had a group called Ex Girlfriend. They had Cheryl Pepsi Rally. She had a bunch of hits, and Full Force themselves had a bunch of hits. They produced for NSYNC. They produced.
I even heard they had a part of Nicki Minaj's early career. I heard.
Yeah. Before Nicki became who she is now, Nicki Minaj used to be in a group with Bowlegged Lou's son. Bowlegged Lou's son, Lou Jr., and Nicki Minaj, long time ago, used to be in a group together. And Nicki used to kind of be under the Full Force wing. I don't know as far as if they were doing music for her. I'm not exactly sure how that worked out, but I know she was affiliated with them through Lou's son back in the day. So, yes, that's definitely true.
Okay, yeah, I just wanted to speak on Full Force and give them their credit, you know what I mean? Because a lot of people, you know, may pass that up in history, you know what I mean? So we got to give them their credit in hip-hop. They did a lot.
One of the first super producers in hip-hop is Full Force. You know, in 84, you know, they hit the scene with I Rock Sam Records. So they've been around, you know, dropping hits since 84 with us.
Right.
They got hits with themselves, and they got pop hits with Lisa. They got pop hits with NSYNC. They produced for Samantha Fox. They produced for James Brown. Hit record. They gave James Brown a big hit record when he came back. That record, Static. I go on and on about Full Force. I mean, for real, just Google them, and that just Augustine speaks for itself, you know, to the listeners out there. Full Force is deeply rooted with a lot of major hits. And thank God we're one of the groups that they were able to bless with some hit records as well.
Right. Shout out to Full Force, man, Bowlegged Lou and the homies, man. Much love. Hey,
yes,
before
indeed.
We continue, let me go to the phone line, man. I got a special caller out there who wants to speak to you. Caller, hello.
Cool, man. I'm looking forward to that.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. How you doing tonight?
Good evening.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
First and foremost, I want to say God bless you, Ice. I want to say rest in peace, man, to the educated rapper. Believe me, man, his contribution in hip-hop was phenomenal, as well as yours. I don't know if you remember me, but you kind of, man, this is kind of deep to me. It's weird. It's weird and spooky that you're on this show tonight, but you were the first East Coast rapper that I ever met personally, and this was back in 1987 or 86. You had came to L.A., and I was hanging out with Richie Rich from the L.A. Dream Team.
Yes.
And my name is Tweed Cadillac. I'm from the Penthouse Players.
Okay.
We hadn't yet made our mark in the world, but we was in L.A., and you were chilling with Rich, and I was there, and he was speaking on me. We already knew who you were, and you spit like a little 16, and I'm sitting in the cut. I think I only had about maybe six rhymes about there. But, man, I spit my 16. We went back and forth, man. I think we even walked to the store to get some. Yes, man. Me and you, and all I had was like six rhymes.
Sam, but I want to make sure we clear about this. This is Mixmaster Ice. You know that, right?
Yes, I do.
There's two Ices in my group. There's Dr. Ice and Mixmaster Ice.
Dr. Ice.
Yeah,
inspired me.
We're talking about Doc. Doc did the rhyme. Doc rhymed. I'm the DJ.
Yeah, Doc. Doc inspired me, man.
Okay.
Back in 1997. And the funny
Doc
part about that,
say,
too,
Doc
was.
Doc used to be out in L.A. a lot, hanging out with Richie and them.
Yeah, and I was right there. And then the ironic part of it, I ended up meeting Special K. Special K came to our studio like in maybe 88, and, man, we had a ball, man. But you guys were the first East Coast rappers.
You're talking about Special
K from
the
Treacherous Three? Yeah. So it's like between Ice and Treacherous Three, you guys were the first East Coast rappers that we met from the West Coast, and I never forgot that scenario. I never forgot that scene.
Okay.
And, man, we always loved East Coast rap. Believe me, man. West Coast never hated on East Coast. Believe me, we wanted y'all respect. We wanted y'all respect.
Thank you, man.
We wanted to be a part of what y'all built. You know, we might have took it in another direction that y'all didn't, but then we always Alibaba'd you, always, man, because y'all was the roots, man. So I'm just glad,
hey, let me tell
man,
you something.
That.
Hey, I appreciate that, and that, what you're saying is true. Back in 88, maybe even late 87, but we were doing a West Coast tour, and we put NWA on that tour with us. They had just hit, like, with a single or two. And while we were doing a bunch of our West Coast dates, we did 14 cities. We did 14 dates on the West Coast, and we put NWA on their first tour with us. And it's funny that you said that, because I remember vividly back then, Ice Cube, especially Ice Cube in particular, me and him really clicked really well. And they really looked up to us, man. Like, they loved East Coast. Of course, they did it with their own little swag to it, but they definitely did respect
man, we loved
where
it.
We came from and what we were
we
doing.
We loved
yeah,
it.
Yeah, they did.
That's
and
where
we loved
it.
They
did.
I snuck in a concert at the Hollywood Palladium with Houdini and everybody. Went and got me some shell toes without the shoestrings, had on some starch jeans. They thought I was from the East Coast. I just eased up in there with everybody and had a ball. And from that point on, I'm like, I'm going to be a rapper. You know what I'm saying?
No doubt.
That's all it took.
What was your rap name? What was your MC
That's
name?
All. Man, I go by the name of Tweet Cadillac. I'm from the Penthouse Players, man. I was signed to Rufus Records and Eazy-E. Eazy-E introduced us to the world. But Ice, your boy, I remember walking, matter of fact, in the 60s, not far from where Nipsey was at, is where Richie Rich and the L.A. Dream Team was based at. And when I met that man, it was like, wow, East Coast rappers is in Cali. Man, we loved it, respected it, wanted to be a part of it, grew, and here we are today, and I'm talking to you. Special K,
man,
big shout out to that
too.
Guy. I know Special K got to remember me because we had him in our studio in South Central L.A. Ain't no way he could say he don't remember us. For real, though. Much love,
hey,
sir.
Hey, man, I appreciate you calling in, man, and much love to you, too, man. Continue blessing.
Man, God bless y'all as well, man.
Much love, Tweet.
Yep.
Legendary Tweet, Cadillac, Penthouse Players Click, man. Also, check out Tweet's show on Thursday
that's
night.
Hey,
93.3 Tweet FM. Yes, sir.
Hey, that's what it's all about.
Ahead,
I'm glad that was a caller that actually, you know, had an opportunity to meet us. Then you know, life is short, so
right.
Sometimes you cross paths and then you cross paths later on again in life. So even though he misinterpreted me for Doc, that's my partner. So it's, you know, it's
right,
still
right,
the same.
Right.
When you speak about Doc,
right,
you speak
right.
about me. That's my brother.
Speak about them all. U.T.F.O.
is
one.
But at the end. Yeah, but at the end of the day, I appreciate him being able to get his call in because, you know, he was there. He was there. He was able to touch us. You know, he was able to be right there and see and witness it, man. So, you know, it's all love.
Hey, much love to Tweet. Hey, Ice, I wanted to ask you as well. We mentioned Houdini. Tell us about what we talked about Full Force, but tell us about what part did Houdini play in UTFO success, if any?
Well, Doc and Kango danced for Houdini. They were dance. We was already a group, UTFO, but before we was making records, Doc and Kango had the opportunity to go on tour with Houdini. They were their break dancers. They were part of their show.
Okay.
So they toured all over Europe with Houdini, and they got their feet wet in the business as a result of Houdini. They got to tour.
Right.
Get to see what the business was like a little bit. So, you know, us coming out as UTFO, Doc and Kang had already been around Houdini, learning a few tricks of the trade, learning about tour life, learning, you know, just the little things that you have to learn from experience. And they were able to get that experience on behalf of UTFO by dancing with Houdini. You know, so of course they're going to share whatever they know with us, and it just helps, you know, just helps our situation a little bit better. But Houdini took them on tour, and they danced with Houdini. Dr. Ice and Jahlil from Houdini are brothers, and those are like our big uncles and big brothers in the game. You know what I'm saying? Houdini, I'm close with them. I always tease Jahlil, and I tell him all the time, yo, man, y'all dudes is like the Frankie Beverly of rap. And he'd be like, nah, man. I'd be like, y'all are like the Frankie Beverly of hip-hop. Houdini can tour forever. They don't ever got to make another record again. The records that they've done, they could tour those records until they are no longer on earth.
Right.
That's how dope the records were they made.
Facts, man. Ice, I want to ask you, somebody wanted me to ask you this, the homie Ali from Philly, not Reverend Ali. What up, Rev? The homie Ali from Philly wanted me to ask you, salute you for being inducted in the Techniques DMC Hall of Fame back
True
in
indeed.
2000.
Thank
you. Yes, sir. We got to give you salutes on that for being recognized. But before that, he wanted to ask, what were some legendary DJ battles that you were a part of in your time, era, or whenever that you can remember?
A lot of the battles I would they would hire me to judge, to be judges at and stuff like that. We toured so much after we first came out.
Battles you had back in the day.
Well, I you know what? I'm gonna share one with you right now. Some people know this, and probably most don't, but I'll share this. It's funny that you brought that up. One of my early battles was a neighborhood battle, and it was how I ended up with the name Mixmaster Ice. My name used to be DJ Ice, and there was a guy in my neighborhood who was using the name. I want to say his name was either Mixmaster John or Mixmaster Wood. Maybe his real name was John and his DJ name was Wood, but it was one of those combinations, either Mixmaster Wood or Mixmaster John. Anyway, I heard that, and I thought that was the dopest name I ever heard in my life. You know, you had Grandmaster Flash. You had Grand Wizard Theodore. You had all these dope DJ names. And I was like, you know, DJ Ice is dope. But I was like, damn, when I heard that Mixmaster, I said, damn, I got to have that. I was like, I thought that was the dopest thing I ever heard. So, of course, you can't bite. Back in our days, you just can't bite somebody's name. And Tango actually knew the guy personally. For us to battle. So the battle was set up, and I was challenging him, so I had to go battle him on his turf, on his stuff. So, you know, make a long story short, we show up, I get to his house, I go on first. I don't even remember what I did. I got on, did a little something, and dude didn't even want to go on. So I won the battle by forfeit. That's how I ended up with the name Mixmaster Ice. My name is because of battling. I battled somebody for the Mixmaster.
Wow.
I come from the battle era, so you know what I'm saying? Yeah.
Yeah, that's why I wanted to ask you, because I wanted to see, like you said, I know you judge some battles, but I wanted to hear one of those classic DJ battles you had yourself, you know, because you come from that era.
Yes, indeed.
Where you had to show and prove.
Yes, indeed.
You know? Couldn't just get up there and be a DJ. You know what I mean? You had to really show and prove. You know, so shout out to you. I want to give a couple shout outs before we continue. Shout out to my homie Snow. If you want to speak, press 1. Anybody out there wants to speak, press 1. Mixmaster Ice is here. You know, he'll speak back to you. Shout out to my homegirl Miss Jean. Shout out to Jane again. My bro CeeLo, he's out there. He said much love to you, Mixmaster Ice. My bro CeeLo. Yes, sir.
4,
yes,
5,
sir.
6, shake him up.
That part. What I want to. Okay. So we talked about the DJ and everything when you came up with UTFO. What were some of the DJs? Since you're a DJ, I want to ask you DJ questions, because I know we don't get enough of that. But I want to know, who are some of the DJs you came up with, or that some of the people. You know, because we had a lot of famous DJs from a lot of famous groups, but who are some of the DJs that you know or looked up to or came up with that don't that you don't feel got the recognition they deserve, but they were official, like that you respected as DJs?
Oh, there's so many. There's so many DJs I respect, man. I respect so many. I respect, man, to be honest with you, man, I respect the culture so much, man. I respect the culture, especially the pioneers before me. I have the utmost
right.
respect for them. Any interview I ever do, I always speak of the pioneers. I call them the bricklayers, the bricklayers. They laid the foundation for us to stand on. When I started DJing, I got my first set of turntables in 1980. The hip-hop wheel was well turning in 1980. So by the time
right.
I hopped on the train, it had already been moving around real heavy. Afrika Bambaataa is a powerhouse name. Of course, our first godfather in hip-hop, the legendary DJ
Kool Herc.
Of course. All
right,
salute.
All right.
Of
all right.
course. The Grand salute. Master Flash of the Furious Five. Salute. Of course.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Grand Wizard Theodore. Salute. Of course. Then you had the Cold Crush Brothers, DJ Charlie Chase and Tony Tone. Salute.
Mm.
DJ Wizkid, R.I.P. Jazzy J with Afrika Bambaataa. Absolutely. Salute. DJ Wizkid, which name you don't hear quite a lot, but he was a monster back then. He won battles and was tearing them boys up back then. Just from way back in the early 80s, DJ Wizkid. He passed away,
right.
but you don't hear his name often, but he's somebody that was very significant in my early developments and studies.
Right.
And I could go on and on and on about DJs, man. The Treacherous Steve, DJ Easy Lee. You know, I mean, I can go on and on. I can name them all, man. I love them all. You talk about DST,
right.
who you know, who
DST.
Was one of
yeah.
the. Of course.
Wow.
I can go on and on and
wow.
on, man. I'm talking about the bricklayers. I'm talking about the pioneers
right.
of this thing. You know, these
right.
are the guys
right.
that I personally looked up to that was already doing it really, really big. I mean, and yeah, love Buck Starsky, DJ Hollywood.
Mm.
There's so many, many names, man, that I can name. You know, like I said, I started in 1980. I'm dropping these names, and I'm talking about with guys that went anywhere from maybe 73 to all the way to 79. You know what I'm saying?
Right, right.
Out there doing it real big. But you know, I can't name everybody, but all the pioneers, y'all know who y'all are, and I've always had nothing but the utmost respect and love for all of them, man, always. And it's funny, you know, they always embrace me like I'm one of them.
Right.
And I guess, you know,
right.
I guess as time progresses, maybe I am one of them now. But I'll be honest, when I'm in the midst of those legends, I still treat them and give them much homage. I'm going to be honest. When I'm around those names I mentioned, I almost get emotional because it's like I remember when it was a time you would have never thought you would have ever met any of them guys. And when I'm around
right,
them
right.
now, it's no big deal. It's like, you know, we all one big family, like we all extended brothers. But those dudes that I'm naming, them guys were DJing in the 70s doing it big. In the 70s, before we had hip-hop records. Before any hip-hop records. Hip-hop didn't even have, hip-hop was rapping off a band. Hip-hop didn't even have producers. A live band came in and dropped some tracks and you rapped over that shit. That's what hip-hop
right.
was back then. Before the beatbox, before the synthesizers and all of that stuff. You know what I'm saying? The MCs and early hip-hop groups, they were rapping and making records off of the live band. When you listen to Curtis Blow, These Are the Bricks, that's a live band playing. When you listen to Sugar Hill Gang, that's a live band. When you listen to King Tim III from the Fatback Band, that's a live band playing. You know what I'm saying? So, but you know, before that, it was the DJ spinning those records that made the MCs dance and rap.
Right. Hey, Ice, let me ask you this, and I don't want to cut you off because you're telling an incredible story. Let me ask you this. Who do you credit for being one of the first DJs to, like you said, we had the band, the rappers were rapping over bands and live bands. Who would you credit one of the first DJs for? Making the break beat, where we break a beat down, and now that changed the game.
I, here's how I, here, I'm going to be honest. There's probably several DJs, and there's probably several DJs that probably don't even get credit for this. But
okay.
I'm going to just speak from my perspective of where I'm qualified to speak.
Okay.
You know, we give Kool Herc a lot of credit for that because Kool Herc threw one of the first hip-hop jams. But let's be clear, Kool Herc is not the first DJ. There was already DJs
okay.
going on. There was already turntables invented. We give Kool
right.
Herc the credit for being to throw one of the first hip-hop parties in the Bronx. Now, a lot stemmed from that park party. But Kool Herc, he wasn't a very technical DJ with the scratching and the tricks and all that. But what Herc
mm-hmm.
did, he was one of the first ones to play the breaks or certain parts of the records for the break dances to dance to. And
okay.
one of the first MCs, which was Coke LaRock, he did a lot of stuff with Kool Herc. So Kool Herc
okay.
was very, very instrumental in the early developments of the hip-hop DJ being able to play in front of a crowd for, you know, the break dances and for an MC or a host. Kool Herc is one of the first for that. You have Bambaataa
okay.
also that's right up there, maybe, you know, right in that same time zone, doing the same thing. And you had Kool Herc and the Herculoids. You had Africa Bambaataa and the Zulu Nation. So there was a whole lot of DJs that came up under Bambaataa. You had Jazzy J,
mm-hmm.
you had Red Alert, you know, you had you know, all of that stuff. Now you go to Grandmaster Flash. Flash,
mm-hmm.
you know, was on a different side of the Bronx doing his thing. What Flash did was he took a little bit of what Bambaataa and what Kool Herc may have been doing, and he revolutionized
right.
it. Flash
okay.
is the one we credit for being able to extend the break. Kool Herc may have been
okay.
one of the first, and Bambaataa may have been one of the first to be able to play the break, but Flash added the technical skill to it to be able to loop the record. Flash is our
okay.
first human sampler, Grandmaster Flash. He is the one that would take the record and figure out how to extend the break. So now an MC can rap on a beat that's flowing without you having to pick the needle up, start it back over. Flash, we give the credit for being able to extend the break on and on and on so that you can dance on beat and rap on beat.
Okay.
Those are our three
okay.
kings right there. Now
okay.
there's probably other kings entwined with them, but I only can speak from the perspective of when I started, which was 1980. Them guys were doing it way before me. But those are three kings that we have to always salute with major salute. Flash,
okay.
Herc, and Bambaataa. All of them.
Okay.
They are hip-hop gods. They are to always be saluted. Always.
Okay. That part, man. Shout out to the gods. I also wanted to ask you, Ice, being that you've been in the game so long, what were some of the most legendary or classic or memorable tours that you've been on? Because I know you've been on a lot, but I know probably those early ones, those are the ones I remember the most. But what were some of the greatest tours that you remember that you were a part of that you appreciate the most in your career?
You got the Fresh Fest. I remember us being on the Fresh Fest. That was major. We was on we was with the Fat Boys on the what was that Fat Boys tour called? It was called the Swim Out. They had a tour that was sponsored by Swatch Watch back then.
Oh yeah,
and
when
the,
they had
and
the
Fat Boys had a real
Wipeout with the Beach Boy.
It was something
before
about
that
swimming.
When
they
had the big
swim.
Song.
What was that thing?
Because they had the Wipeout with the Beach
yeah.
Boys.
Yeah, the Wipeout. That's what it was. The Wipeout tour. I think it was called the Wipeout tour. We was with
okay.
them. It was us, Fat Boys, the Boogie Boys, Rockmaster Scott and the Dynamic Three. Who else was there? I mean, it was so many people back then touring with us. And then us and Curtis Blow, we toured together. We co-headlined together. Awesome tours. And then
I bet that was
by
big.
Our second album, yes, by our second album, we started headlining our own tours. And Salt and Pepper used to open up for us. Heavy D used to open up for us. Dana Dane, the L.A. Dream Team. MC Hammer used to open up for us when he first came out. The 357.
Wow.
Oh yeah, all of them. All of them used to open up for us. I mean, I can go on and on and on. We Dougie Fresh did a lot of shows with us back then. The Force and D's. And we was headlining back then. Back then we were the top dogs. You know, we was right up there with them. Right up there with DMC. We was right up there with them. But we was on, you know, we was doing our thing and they was doing their thing. But we was a headlining powerhouse back then. I would say from 86 all the way to 89, we was headlining our own tours.
Wow. Yeah, because you came first.
Yeah.
You know,
we put NWA. NWA on that first tour.
Wow.
We put Too Short. We put Too Short on his first tour with us. Yes.
Wow.
We put MC Hammer.
Wow.
Hammer first tour was opening up for us. Heavy D, Salt and Pepper, all of them used to open up for us back then. We was all out there getting that money and traveling.
Wow. That's history, ladies and gentlemen. History. History.
I remember when EPMD first came out, they did dates with us. I remember Eric B and Rakim when they first came out, they was doing dates with us. I mean, it goes on and on and on.
Right, right. And being that you came out, you were one of the first and you were early. Who were some of the artists, like you named so many, all of them went on to have success. Who were some of the artists that you, not most surprised, but seen something in them early, like you said, when they opened up for you or you ran across, that you later seen blossom and become great, that you believed in early, that you seen coming up, you know what I mean?
I knew NWA was going to blow up because their energy was amazing. You just knew it. And you could hear the records. You could hear how well they was produced. You knew they was going to blow. You knew it. I'm going to tell you who really, really I'll never forget. And every time we run into each other, we hug and we share the same story. Too Short. I'll never forget. We did the Oakland Coliseum. And this is when Roxanne was really big. We were still touring off the Roxanne leg. And we did a show in the Oakland Coliseum. Too Short wasn't even, he probably was just a mixtape guy at the time. Didn't even have any records out. He was at the show. And I'll never forget this. I used to always like to listen to the opening act so I could see the energy that they bring in and see the energy of the crowd.
Right.
I always had a thing for that. So I'm backstage in Oakland, just chilling, checking out the show. And this little short dude, Too Short looked real young. He's a little short, young-looking nigga. So he come out there, and he's standing backstage. He got the mic in his hand. This dude say one word, and the whole stadium went crazy. I've never seen no shit like that ever in my life. Am I not a cuss? I'm cussing. Is it cool to cuss?
Yeah, yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, okay.
Well, yeah, you say what you want to say, bro.
I'm cussing. I get emotional about this. You feel me? Listen. So Too Short gets it. He's on the mic. Too Short didn't even hit the stage, and he's just backstage. And he was like, bitch. And the whole stadium. The whole stadium screamed him back. So I said, what the hell just happened? So I'm in shock. I've never seen nothing like that happen before. Especially with a curse word. So he said it again. Bitch. And the whole crowd said it again. And then he said, drop that beat, DJ. And DJ dropped the beat. I don't remember what it was. And Too Short came out on stage rapping. The whole stadium went crazy. Too Short didn't even have a record. He didn't even have a record. And they were going crazy.
Wow.
I've never seen nothing like that in my life. But what really tripped me out was the fact that he said one word and he commanded the whole crowd off of one word. He wasn't even on stage yet. I've never seen nothing like that in my life. And I was very impressed by that. And every time I see Too Short, we always talk about that. It's one of
Too
Short's first shows he ever did was opening up for us in Oakland.
Wow.
His first sold-out show. It was a sold-out show in Oakland, and Too Short opened up for us. And I'm pretty sure that was one of his first. I'm sure that was his biggest first show, for sure. But that was one of his first shows that he ever did
Wow. Wow.
Yes.
Shout out to the
He'll never forget
Too
that.
Short.
I'll never forget that. Shout out to Too
Yeah, he's
Short.
A legend in Oakland.
I remember that to this day.
Interviewed a lot of Oakland cats, man, legends, and they always say Too Short was, you know, the inspiration. He did it
yes.
first, man. So, and he's still doing it, like yourself. You know,
and
he's
still
salute
doing
that,
it.
Man.
Still,
yeah, man.
Salutes. Could never make it ever
yeah.
again either. He could pull off
yeah.
the records he got for the rest of his life.
Right, right.
And this had to be back maybe 85, 86, I'm talking. This had to be
right.
This had to be about 85, 80. This was early when he opened up for us. I want to say maybe 86. It had to be between
mm-hmm.
85 and 87 for sure. But I want to say this might be closer to 85, 86 because the Roxanne record was still hot. So I want
right.
to say this might have been still in 85. Maybe, matter of fact, I'm pretty sure it had to be either 85 or 86. But I'm going to kind of lean towards maybe late 85. But I just remember him saying that one word, bitch, and the whole 7,000,
yes.
5,000, how many people was in there, said it back. I never seen nothing like
wow.
that in my life. And he wasn't even on stage. He was behind the stage. They couldn't even see him yet. He just happened to say it on the corner of his mic.
Right. Wow. Wow. Shout out
yeah,
to Too Short, man.
Short.
You got
Shout
some legendary stories. I know you've seen it all. That's why I wanted to ask you, you know, who were some of the people that you've seen early on that you thought may make it? And Too Short, definitely, he's a legend just like yourself, you know, especially in Oakland.
Man,
but
let me tell you something. I knew
all over the world.
I can go on and on and on. I can go on and on and on. I knew Hammer was going to blow. He was a dancing machine. Nobody could dance like Hammer at that time. And
right.
he had records that had a lot of energy. And he was killing. His stage show was killer. MC Hammer was
mm-hmm.
dope. I knew he was going to blow up. And he had some girls with him. He had the 357 chick dancing for him.
Right, right.
And I was like,
hey,
dude, he going to blow. I knew Hammer was going to blow. I knew NWA was going to blow.
Hey, Ice, let me ask you this real briefly. Speaking on Hammer, I know that like you said, you knew what he was doing and you could respect it. Did you already know, because you come from a group like UTFO under Houdini, and like you said, where it was a stage show, and you put on a show and did different things. So Hammer came and did the same thing in entertainment as far as doing his dance thing, but you know, there was a lot of people that dissed Hammer back in the day. What did you feel about that whole thing, how they felt about Hammer coming from New York?
Well, of course New York is going to be, you know, of course New York is real East Coast oriented. You know what I mean? And
right.
back then, you know, New York was just hardcore on New York. So, you know, New York is a respect thing. So back then, New York really didn't have a whole lot of respect for anybody else outside of New York. That's just how New York was
right.
in the early development. You know?
Right.
New York is the mecca of the East Coast, just like L.A.
Right.
is the mecca of the West Coast. You know,
right.
Atlanta is the mecca of down south. That's just what it is.
Right.
You know what I mean? But
right.
regardless of whether you like somebody or not, you're going to respect numbers. At the end
right.
of the day, Hammer put up numbers. Hammer's one of the first, if not the first, he's one of the first hip-hop artists to go diamond. MC
yeah,
Hammer
I think,
had an
well,
album
yeah.
that...
Yeah.
MC
yeah.
Hammer had an album that sold 10 million plus copies. Not too many
mm-hmm.
people could say they have an album that did that. MC Hammer
mm-hmm.
has one of those. And MC
yeah.
Hammer is one of the first hip-hop groups that toured around the world selling out arenas. Back
mm-hmm.
then. Back then.
Yeah.
And I remember
yeah.
when Hammer blew up, Hammer was one of the first ones getting big, big money. I'm talking big money. Million dollar gigs. Selling
yeah.
out arenas. Getting a $1 million bag. He was one of the
right.
first ones getting that kind of bread. Hammer, yes. So I watched his development from when he was opening up for us to when his first, when he blew up and went diamond and all of that. You know, yo, Hammer was one of the first ones that was really getting big, big money. He's one of the first ones. And he's a solo artist. So he didn't have to split
right.
money with a whole lot of people. But
he had a whole,
you know,
he had a hell of an entourage,
deal.
Though.
He had a hell,
he
but
had
you
a
know
hell
what? That was all part of his show. He had one
right,
hell
right.
of a show. I don't know how many dances he used to have, But that's
yeah.
That's what his thing was. But
yeah.
I'm gonna keep it real. Before Hammer had all of that, it was just him, the 357 chick, and maybe a couple of other people. The focus was on
okay.
him back then. You know, he
right.
was Hammer was one man. He could dance his tail off. He was off
yeah,
the
yeah.
chain
he,
back then. See, Kango and Doc were
dancing. Still
so
doing
we,
it. Yeah,
yeah, we, yeah, Kango and Doc were big time dancers. So, you know.
Right.
If I'm telling you Hammer was nice, then Hammer was nice. Hammer was
right,
dope.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And when and with the baggy pants, it made it look even more dope.
Right, right, right.
You know what I mean? That's when the baggy pants, that's when that baggy pants era was going on. And when you
right.
danced in them baggy pants, it just made it look like you was floating on air, man.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Shout out to
yeah,
Hammer, man.
Hammer was dope. Hammer was
yeah,
dope,
shout
man. Hammer was dope. He used to open up for us. He was dope.
Wow. Yeah, man.
He was dope.
You got to see it all, man. Rest in peace to the homie. What do you think overall of the UTFO legacy that you take, man? That
Hello? I don't know. I don't know if you're still there or not. I don't know if I'm still on the air. If I'm still on the air, big up everybody that's still listening. I don't hear the host right now, so I don't know what happened. Maybe he'll call me back, or maybe I should just hang up or call back. I'm not sure what's going on. I don't know if y'all still hear me or not, but if y'all do still hear me,
yeah.
It's Mixmaster.
Yeah, I hear you now. You hey. Stop for a minute. We hear you now. What
did you hit
okay.
the mute button?
I don't know. Nah, I don't know. You
oh.
were just out. I think you hit mute. But we got you now.
No,
we
I didn't hit anything. I got you on loudspeaker. I ain't touched nothing.
Okay. I don't know what happened, bro, but we got you now. So go ahead.
Okay. Cool. What was the question again?
I know we got thrown off. I was going to ask you what do you think overall of UTFO's legacy that you feel most you know, appreciative of, and maybe some of the things you don't, because I know later you guys split up and whatever, everybody did their own thing. One of the homies went away. What is your overall legacy of UTFO in your opinion, and what the people should take from UTFO?
Well, we lost one of my best friends that I've ever had, which was Educated Rapper. He was my first hip hop partner, and we grew up together as teenagers. You know, went to the same high school together, ran the same streets together, started together in hip hop, and I lost him 2 years ago to cancer. He died of cancer 2 years ago, and I was with him. I was living in Ohio at the time, but I flew home and spent the last 3 days of his life with him while he was in the hospital. And you know, when he transitioned on to heaven, I was sitting right there with him. You know, talking to him all the
wow.
way to the end. Tell him how much I love him, how much I'm going to miss him. And that was hard. But, you know, life goes on. God makes no mistakes. And you just got to keep, you know, keep on talking. So, you know, salute
right.
to my partner. Salute to the Educated Rapper, EMD. You know, UTFO, myself, Mixmaster Ice, Tango Kid, Dr. Ice, and rest in peace, Educated Rapper. We made history together. We shocked the world back in 84. And we were blessed to be able to make one of hip-hop's greatest records of all time,
yes.
Roxanne, Roxanne.
Yes.
That is one
yes.
of hip-hop's greatest records.
Yes.
It sprung over maybe 25 ASA records. No record
yes.
in the history of music or hip-hop ever had that many responses.
Yes.
We were blessed to be able to do 5 albums, put out a greatest hits, and tour the world, and enjoy to do what we did. You know, as time progressed, we grew apart creatively. Dr. Ice went solo, and during our fourth album, Dr. Ice branched off and started a solo career. And we continued to go ahead and make another album after that. But our four-man ingredient wasn't there. Then we started having creative differences with the remaining members. And it just came to a point where we just phased out and went our own separate ways.
Right.
We unfortunately have not reunited as a four-man crew. Well, we're missing one now, but we had not reunited as a four-man crew. There had been attempts by us to try to reunite, but, you know, things just wasn't.
I know.
The stars just weren't aligned.
I know you're missing out on some tours.
The stars just weren't aligned.
I know you're missing out on some great tours, though.
Yeah. Oh, I'm pretty sure we missed out on a lot of things. However, I'll say this. God makes no mistakes. So I know God is, I trust the process. I'm going to say this. I trust the process because whatever we may be missing out on, we may not be missing out on. You know, at the end of the day, we may be missing out on things and maybe we're not. Maybe this is what God's plans are. But we're all still doing our thing. I stay busy. Doc stays busy. Kang stays busy. So we're not really missing out on anything. We're just missing out on a collective group touring as a collective group.
Right.
You know, at the end of the day, if it's meant to be for us to get back together, it will happen. If it's not meant to be, then I have fully, truly enjoyed the ride of what we did do. And I'm truly blessed to be able to been a part of a great group and to do some of the great things that we've done. Now, if God mends the pieces back together with the remaining three members and we're able to put that together and go back on the road, our fans are going to go crazy because our fans have not seen us together probably since the early, early 90s. We're probably one of the very few hip-hop groups that have not reunited as a unit yet. There's still a few others that haven't, but we're one of the few that have, you know.
Right.
And, you know, a lot of groups have reunited. Look at Rakim and Eric B. They was apart for a long time.
Yeah.
So they got back together. Who, you know, EPMD got back together. So don't nobody out there outrule the fact that UTFO won't get back together. It could very well happen. It's just in God's hands. You know, I'm just going to be honest about that. You know, the next time, we might be talking next week. We on the world tour. But, you know, I love my fellas. I love Kang. I love Doc. It's just that right now, you know, the honest answer is we just haven't reunited as a unit back yet. You know, and when the blessings come that we do, I'm sure we're going to tour and make up for a whole lot of lost ground. Because there's a lot of ground for us to make up.
Mm-hmm. There it is, man. Mixmaster Ice.
But as far as the legacy, man, our fans keep us alive, man, and you know, and that's the blessing of it, man. Getting your roses and getting your acknowledgments while you're still alive, and things of that nature, man. You know what I mean? Because we're not getting any younger, and you know, some of us are not here anymore. You know what I mean? So
right.
You're alive as long as your fans keep you alive, and I truly love my fans. And I'm speaking for the group when I say that. We have some of the best fans to this day, you know, and as far as the UTFO legacy, we were blessed, you know, to do some of the things that we've done, man. And I don't take anything for granted at all. It's all been a blessing and one enjoyable ride. You feel me?
Yes, sir. And we as fans, man, enjoy the ride as well. I've been there with you since day one, man. UTFO.
Thank you.
The Roxanne era. Somebody wanted me to ask you that, my brother, about the Roxanne era, how that took off. Were you guys surprised how that took off? And, yeah, Roxanne Shante, you guys brought out the real Roxanne, which everybody loved, even though, you know, Roxanne was, like, more hood with it and more, you know, but a lot of people felt they didn't know what was up with Roxanne where you know what I mean? It was just like a industry thing, but everybody loved Roxanne, man, the real Roxanne that you guys put out. How was that thing?
Here's the story. We made a record called Roxanne, Roxanne. Roxanne, Roxanne wasn't even supposed to be the hit record. Roxanne was the B-side to a record called Hanging Out. Hanging Out was the A-side, and that was the record that we was coming out with the record company. The record company in Full Force suggested that we do a B-side, so we threw together a B-side. And when I say throw together, Roxanne, Roxanne was really a throw-together record. EMD's verse was a verse we used to do at the block party, and the whole concept of the record came from B-side from Full Force. When it was time to write the record, And I guess Kang and them was like, well, you know, what should we do? What should we make a record about? And B-Sign suggests they're thinking about a girl. And so they was like, okay, who? And he was like, I don't know, Roxanne. So B-Sign is the one that threw the name Roxanne in the air. I don't know if he dated a girl named Roxanne in high school or where the name Roxanne came from. The record could have been called Susan Susan. It could have been called Mary Mary. The song could have been called anything. It's just that the name they went with was Roxanne. So they wrote a rap around the name Roxanne. But Roxanne didn't exist. The girl that we wrote the record about did not exist. The record, if you listen to the record is about three guys battling each other about a girl they couldn't get. So Kango, Doc, and EMD are battling each other on the record about the girl that neither of them got, which was this made-up name called Roxanne Roxanne. So that's what the record was about. But the record was dope. You know, people loved it. So the record took off. Sha'Tae was entering a talent show, and we had an instrumental to Roxanne Roxanne. So everybody loved rapping off the big beat part. That's the part where EMD's rapping. The boom, pa-pa, boom, pa, boom, pa-pa. That was, you know, that's a break beat. We wanted the first hip-hop records to have a break beat in our record. So everybody loved that part. When that part would go on, everybody would go crazy. So a lot of people like to rap for that anyway. So in the talent show, Sha'Tae wrote a rap to that part. And it just so happened, she flipped our record and wrote the rap about, she flipped the record and made it like more of a joke, but it was like, in the talent show, she flipped the record and made it like it was like she was Roxanne. Okay.
Wow. So she performed Roxanne first in front of you all.
No, we didn't even know her. We didn't know her. Okay. We didn't know her from a can of paint.
She performed that first.
No. What happened is we didn't even know nothing about this talent show. I'm just telling you how she got started. So as a result of that talent show, I don't know if it was Mr. Magic or the label or who, somebody light bulbs went off. And they was like, yo, we got something here. So they took her in the studio and had her do that little verse and that little record she did. I think they told her to write two more verses to it. We want you to rap over the instrument. We want you to rap over the UTFO instrumental. And she did that. She went in the studio, probably with Marley Marl, and rapped over our instrumental. They took that and pressed it up and made a record out of it. That was her first answer to us. They pressed up her rapping to our instrumental. They went in and pressed that up and put that out. That's how we first heard of her.
Okay.
As a result of that, of course we was pissed. We was like, what's that? You know, who does that? You know, how dare she answer? How dare she diss our record and blah 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 this blah blah. So we was naturally pissed. And the label ended up suing her for that because you can't take somebody instrumental and do that. But they sued her too early. If they would have waited till her record peaked and then sued her, might have been a different ball game. But our record and the momentum was still so big, they were able to go in and redo the record. So the record that you hear, Roxanne Revenge, that's Marley Marl recreating the record.
Okay.
You understand what I'm saying? So if you listen to it, it sounds similar to ours. His scratches are similar to mine, but if you listen to it, you can clearly hear the difference. But they were able to go in and redo the record, and that's how the Roxanne Revenge came out. So when that happened, we ended up going in the studio and creating the real Roxanne.
Okay.
The real Roxanne. Because Sha'Tae wasn't who we were talking about. But since we want to put a face to this thing, we're going to put our own face to it. And that's how the real Roxanne came into play.
Okay.
We created the real Roxanne because of what Sha'Tae had done.
And how did you find the real Roxanne?
You know what I'm saying? Oh, I think one of Full Force may have found it. I don't know if they may have had auditions. They may have had auditions. I'm not exactly sure, but they may have had auditions, or maybe one of them knew her, knew she was up and coming or trying to rap or something, because we wrote the rap. Oh, well, you know what? Well, let me say this. Let me say this, because I'm going. The real Roxanne that you guys know is not the original real Roxanne that we had. We had the girl that's rapping on the record is a different girl that ended up doing the album.
Hey, you know what? You know what? You said that. It's crazy you said that, because I had a song. I played the real Roxanne, but I had another one I wanted to play, but I wind up playing the other one, and that was a different version. I heard that. I thought I was tripping. I heard that was a different version.
So the girl that's rapping on the real Roxanne record, that was a girl named Elise. She was the first real Roxanne. She was with us for a few months, and then things didn't work out. I can't remember what exactly happened, but something didn't work out, and we had to replace her with another Roxanne. When we replaced her, with a girl named Joanne. And that's the Roxanne that you guys are familiar with as far as the face goes. She's the one that did the Bang Zoom record with Howie T, and she's the one that got the album deal. But she's not the one rapping on the – but she's not the one rapping – on the Roxanne record.
I caught that.
She's the one that but she is the one that got the album deal. So she's the one that's on the album.
She was bad too back in the days. I'm sure that helped, because it was like this
was
real rock.
Yes.
People didn't like they looked, you know what I mean? It was commercial, but it was like she was bad.
She was Puerto Rican. She's one of the first Puerto Rican female rappers in the business.
She was bad.
Sure was.
Yeah, she was.
Yep,
she was bad.
She got a career out of it. And then after that, Sparky D got involved. Sparky D battled Shantae. And then after that happened, it was a major phenomenon. There was this Roxanne records coming out of the woodwork. Roxanne's a man. Mm-hmm. Roxanne's dog. Do the Roxanne
son.
Dance. Roxanne grandparents.
Yeah.
Roxanne's son. It was just tons and tons and tons of these Roxanne records coming out all over the world. It was crazy.
Yep. It was, man. It was a hell of a ride, man. You got to witness it all, you know what I mean? And to see hip hop go from where it started to where it is now, I know it's a major shift, and we talked about this earlier, but it's a major difference in where hip hop is today. But what do you see about the growth of hip hop? Where do you see the future of hip hop going? It's a lot of money. I can say that. It's a lot of money now being generated, but it's definitely a totally different shift. And where do you see hip hop, you know, future of hip hop from your perspective, being where it came from and where it is now?
Hip hop has a lot of dimensions, it has a lot of layers now. You still have the purists, you still have legends around that tour, and you have the new generation, you know, the up and coming artists of the day. Technology is different now than it was back then. The way we record it is different, the way we DJ is different. And the way stages, things are a lot different now than back then. But there are still artists that still have the back then elements in them. And for me personally, I love hip hop. I love the old and I love the new. My only thing with the young generation is this. I don't have a problem with what they do. That's just me personally. I don't have a problem with it, because UTFO, we were one of the first filthy mouth MCs in the business. If you listen to some of my early records, we was off the chain. You know, we was off the chain back then. Especially on our third album. We had Master Baby. We had Get Down, Pull Your Pants Down, All I Wanna Do. Yeah. We was off the hook back then. So I'm in no position to criticize any of these young guys, especially if they're feeding their families. Because there was a time when we were young and we were off the chain, and I remember hearing stories about people getting whoopings, their parents beating them because they was listening to UTFO, and UTFO has got ratchet lyrics, and you know. So I understand. My only thing with the rappers of today is this: learn the history of who paved the way before you. Hip-hop is the only genre of music where the young generation does not know their legend. And that is terrible.
Fact.
Rock and roll,
fact.
They know their legends. The jazz era, new up-and-coming jazz artists, they know their legends. Rock and roll, heavy metal, they know their legends. Gospel music, they know their legends. Hip-hop is the only era where it's a serious divide. And I just wish that divide didn't exist. Because clearly, if every other music can do it, why are we slacking?
Yes, fact.
You know, the young do not respect the old, and the old do not respect the young. Only
fact.
In hip-hop do you have that problem. You don't have that in no other form of music. Not in country music, the old respect the new artist, and the new artist respect the old artist. It's facts. The same way in everything, but only in hip hop do you have these problems. It's a serious divide. Hip hop is very competitive. The other music are not as competitive as hip hop. Hip hop is very, very competitive driven. So, you know, but that's my only gripe with hip hop. I wish the young generation would know their legends, know who paved the way for you to do what you're doing. That's my only thing with that. That's my only thing with that.
And
you know, especially if you're sampling records
way.
Off of people. Yeah, if you're sampling a record off of hip hop, reach out to that brother and get him in your video. Sometimes that's all it takes.
Right.
Just reach out to him and say, "Hey man, I sampled your record. You know, I'd like to get you on my video." Just reach out.
Right.
You know,
that's just
me personally. I just wish that divide wasn't as relevant as it is. It's unfortunate, but, you know, it is what it is. And I'll say this also for the young generation, because I don't have a major problem with them. I just wish some of them would put a little more balance in their music as far as, you know, when I say balance, I mean something of some consciousness. You know, I know you're from the streets. I know you're from the hood. We all from the hood. We all came up from the same shit. I mean, I understand. And you know, Project Life is what it is. I know all about it. We all from the hood, you know. But just put a little balance in your music, because at the end of the day, whether we want to or not, we are role models. You know, some of us are just good role models and some of us are terrible role models. But we are role models whether we want to be or not. The youth looks at what we do. And they either appreciate it, try to emulate it, or whatever the case may be, they watching us. So, you know, at some aspects, man, we do need to be conscious of that. You know what I'm saying? Old and new. You know, the youth are watching us. And the youth is always going to be the future. The youth is the future. You know, we're old now. So, and then the up-and-coming artists, you're going to be old eventually. You know, so, you know, just always remember, the youngins is watching us, man. And give them some nourishment. You know, something that they, when I say nourishment, I mean that balance, that good balance. Not everything got to be ratchet. Not everything got to be dropping like it's hot, even though I know that needs to be there as well. But give these youth some balance so that they can see both sides of the pendulum, you know. And that's just my only thing, man. I just wish it was just a little more balance for the babies to see. Because there's babies watching this stuff now. You know what I mean?
Yes, sir. Facts. Mixmaster Ice. Ladies and gentlemen, and in closing, Ice, tell the people where they could reach you at if they want to get at you for business or follow you or your platform. They want to get in tune with what you have going on or get the history. Let them know, let everybody know where they can reach you at or follow you at.
Please do. I appreciate that.